It fights. Why do you think there's a war going on in your members? You have to think that. Because the spirit is telling you one thing, but your flesh is battling, trying to do the right thing, because we have allowed so much to get in our flesh till you have a hard time doing what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. But see, tonight God want to break your flesh. He wants you to submit your flesh. Come on here. He wants you to align your flesh. He wants you to align your flesh with the Spirit of God. He wants you to align your flesh with the will of God. But see, when you don't have, I'm telling you, when you're really not walking in the Spirit, you're going to fail.
That's good, Apostle. That's good.
Yes. Right. Anytime your flesh has more control over the spirit, it means that you have become comfortable listening and operating and entertaining your flesh.
That's it. That's good, Apostle.
So, but God wants everyone in here to understand, those of you, because there are some people in here. Is some that you really believe in allowing the Spirit to deal with you. Yes. There's some in here. Yes. But there's a whole lot of you in here. You've made fleshy decisions. Yes. And you're having a hard time in life. Yes. Come on, because the Spirit of the Lord is talking. You're having a hard time in life because for so long your flesh, your flesh. You've been interrupted for doing for God's sake, because your flesh needs to be satisfied. And when I say satisfied, I'm not just talking about sex, because we always think everything is about sex, even though that's 80% of the church problem. It is.
It is. It is.
I'm going to say, man, I'm going to look straight at the door. But you know, this is true. 80% of what's causing a lot of us to fall is the word S-E-X. Come on, somebody.
You ain't lying.
You do it. See, you ain't lying. I understand.
Yeah.
The Bible tells us to abstain from fornication. Because once you meet that connection with somebody that is not your husband, you begin to take on the spirit like he's supposed to be your husband. You begin to do things for him like he's your husband.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-oh, I don't walk here.
Come down.
Come on, let me walk this floor a little bit. Let me talk to the saints of God. I'm serious. I need y'all to listen to me. This is why some of y'all are hurting. This is why that man can get you to do whatever he wants. Because technically, strategically, in the beginning, God had ordained for man and woman to become one. It was orchestrated in the beginning of time for man and woman to come together, and for her to serve him, and for him to love her. Flesh of my flesh, and what? Bone of my bone. So the way you're feeling, it is natural, but it's done out of the wrong, in the wrong time.
The wrong timing. Come on.
Help, Lord. Help the church.
You did it at the wrong time. See, now, and see, what really makes it bad is now you did it once. You want to do it again and again and again. And let me tell you something. It really isn't wrong to want to do it again and again, but it's wrong when it's not done in marriage.
Well.
Because this is the way God orchestrated. He orchestrated man and woman to come together for fleshly pleasure, to love one another, to be passionate. He didn't create it like that. He created the man to look at his woman and be able to cause her to want to melt and just be in his arms. And oh my God.
Yeah, Lord.
Yes, he did do it.
Yeah, Lord.
But the problem is we doing it at the wrong time. And
yeah.
We're struggling to get Harry out of our spirit. We're struggling to get John out of our spirit. We're struggling to get Joel out of our spirit. Because now, because it felt so good, he done left you, and now you're trying to find another man. Come another man that you gotta yoke your the man's spirit inside of you. I'm going a little deep now. But y'all talk all
this is good.
This stuff anyway. Y'all just behind closed doors. So just let me kind of go a little deeper. Can I go a little deeper?
Go deeper.
I'm just going to lay it there. When the man releases into you, you get everything of him.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
User.
Yes.
Yeah. Everything. Everything. His whole DNA. Everything.
Because he don't just blow your flesh, he blow your mind. Yeah. Now you sitting up at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning like, if I could just see, you want him to touch you again, see? And see,
yes, Lord Jesus.
God did create for you to feel like that. He did create for the man to release.
That bite, Lord.
You just want him, see? Have you noticed that the man you sleep with, you just want him. He's what you want. You have a passion for him. You just want to spend the rest of your life. God really ordained it that way. But guess what we did wrong? We got in our flesh and we took the law into our own hands.
That's it.
That's good, Apostle.
Now you're struggling. You're struggling. And now the enemy has created all kinds of now there's so much going on now, and you're trying to find a way, how can I keep myself satisfied? And now some of you now can go deeper. Oh, Lord, I didn't know he was going to take it in.
You better flow like he said it.
You are suffering from masturbation because now you have no man, so you have to masturbate to get the feeling.
Go there. You're in the church. It's going on.
Yes, she walking in it.
You got to go there. Yeah. You do.
It's the truth.
If it ain't that, you gotta go buy a toy.
What?
You gotta do something to get it. Oh, you don't have to. Listen. I ain't trying to expose you. I never called your name. But I'm trying to help you understand why you're doing what you're doing. It all happened with just tapping it one time out of marriage.
Teach, Apostle. You gotta teach it.
Not only are you addicted to sex, now you're addicted to masturbating.
Yep.
So now there's another spirit on top of the spirit. Because when you have sex before marriage, it opens up doors for other things.
Yes.
Why? Because you did it out of the law that God created. Anything that you do outside out of the law of God can create a lot of dysfunctionalism. So now you're struggling with masturbation. Now you need something to keep you going. But the Lord says that he can break that. If you really, he said he can break anything. Don't be ashamed of it. But God wants you, don't want you walking around touching yourself. I can't feel like that. If I'm going to do that,